Hi everyone, welcome back to the Phoebe Way. On this channel, we talk about life in Germany, legal issues, social issues, everything that concerns you as an expat. There is a lot that I have for you in store today, so do not go anywhere. Watch this video to the end. And if you have not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Subscribe, activate the notification button so that anytime an informative video goes up, you'll be one of the first to know. So if you've noticed, last month I did the updates on laws that have come into effect in the month of October, and today being the last Sunday in November, I'm bringing to you the new updates on laws that have become effective in the month of November 2021. Without further ado, let's just start with this. So you might have noticed that in Germany we start the Advent cycle, so the time of Advent, the time before Christmas, and it starts with the Christmas markets and everything. Usually they should have started this weekend, but unfortunately Munich started the trend. They canceled theirs, and then it was followed, for me in the south, was followed by Esslingen, Ludwigsburg, and also Stuttgart. Even though the Stuttgart mayor had announced that it would take place the previous weekend, he said it would happen. And I was in Stuttgart, I saw the huts and everything being built, and I was so excited. I was just keeping my fingers crossed, but unfortunately it did not happen. So yes, updates, most of the Christmas markets are being canceled. So please check for your city and see what that means for you. And yeah, currently there are talks of lockdown, but nothing concrete yet. If there's any update, of course, you know. So check the community tabs. If the community tab of this channel, if there's any extra news that I have to bring to you, I'll put that on the community tab. Or check out our Facebook page, I'll put the information there as well, because sometimes it's just concise information. I don't have to make a full video on that, I can just put the information there for you to read. So check that as well if you want it compact and concise and short. Yes, that is where to go. Join our Facebook group as well, the Phoebe Way group on Facebook as well. And if not yet, check out our Instagram, please do, or Twitter as well. Follow me on Twitter at the Phoebe Way. So that is on the lighter side, or on the sadder side. Good news for non-vaccinated people. As I told you last month, people who are not yet vaccinated have to pay for their rapid test, not the PCR, but the rapid test. And I think it was between 10 and 15 euros. My friend of mine did hers, I think it was 15. So the price is different. But now, because of the rise in the cases, it is free again for everyone. So the rapid test, the antigen test, are free. It's the PCR that everybody has to pay, and that some places starts from 60 euros. So you don't have to wait to get tested, you don't have to hesitate to get tested. Rapid tests are free for everyone. Also, if you are not yet vaccinated and you are going to work, you have to produce a rapid test daily. So it's good that that one is free. You have to produce a rapid test daily or a PCR test every second day, and that one costs money. And that time that you take to go do the test is not part of your working hours, so you have to plan in more time to go take the test and report to work on time. So keep that in mind. If you are not yet vaccinated, you have to make sure that you do those tests. Okay, so that is for Corona. Now, drivers, we have to be very, 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 very careful, because the traffic rules have become even more and more strict. So most of the fines have been doubled for wrong parking, for example, for over speeding. I'm just going to blend that in here. I'm just going to show you guys the current list. So for speeding in town, most of the fines have been doubled. So up to 10 kilometers per hour, it used to be 15 euros, now it's 30 euros. Between 11 to 15 kilometers per hour, used to be 25, now that is 50 euros, sorry. And then between 16 to 20 kilometers, it used to be 35 euros, now that is 70 euros. And then the most interesting part is that if you exceed the speed limits in town between 26 to 30 kilometers per hour, it used to be 100 euros, now it is a whole 180 euros. You get 1 point in Flensburg, and then you also get 1 month of a driving ban. So beware of that.
Now let's get into speeding out of town. So speeding out of town used to be 10 euros up until 10 kilometers per hour. That is 20 euros now, and it goes on. So 40 used to be 20, 60 used to be 30 euros, for example. And if you exceed by 21 to 25 kilometers per hour, the price is 70 euros. It's no more 70 euros, by 100 euros, and you get a point. But once you exceed by 26 to 30 kilometers per hour, it's now no more 80 euros, but 150 euros. You get 1 point, just as if you exceeded between 21 and 25 kilometers per hour, and you get 1 month driving ban if you are a repetitive offender. And then if you exceed between 31 to 40 kilometers per hour, you have to pay between around 200 euros and no more 120 euros. You get a point as well, and 1 month as well, 1 month ban if you keep doing it. And as you can see, the list keeps going on and on, but I have just stopped at 26 to 30 kilometers per hour, because I'm assuming you're not going to go 70, more than 30 kilometers per hour, exceed that. So please watch out for that and just stick to the rules. Now let's go on to parking violations. So if you park in a place that is prohibited to park for more than an hour, it's 40 euros. For less, it's 25. If you park on a space confined to rescue vehicles, or you obstruct the path of rescue vehicles, that is also something that you're going to be fined for. If you park on a restricted areas in second row, if you're parking in second row, there's something you can be fined for as well. And these points are new. Usually we're not getting points for that earlier, but now you get points for that. And also one thing you should know in Germany is that it is forbidden to park 5 meters in front of crossovers or side roads, and it's 8 meters if there is a cycle path. So please watch out for that. A lot of people do not know, especially people who are new here. So once you realize that there is a crossroad, you cannot just park until the end of the road. You have to be 5 meters distance to the end of the road, right? On side roads or crossovers. So that is one thing that you should know and you should watch out for. Let's continue. And also know that you cannot block the emergency lane if you're on the autobahn, if you're anywhere that there's been an emergency lane created for rescue vehicles. Please wait and let everybody drive. You don't have to follow the emergency vehicle or the ambulance or the police car. That is also going to attract a fine of about, used to be 200, but now it's going to be 400 euros. Any action that causes danger to pedestrians, like branching off the road without checking whether a pedestrian is crossing the road or not, that is also going to attract fines. So please, please, please be careful. Flensburg is not smiling. The state is not smiling. Keep your money in your pocket and be safe out there.
And also be careful about your points in Flensburg, because you know that once you cross 8 points, you lose your driver's license for good. So please, please be careful on these streets, Charlie. Maybe I is slow free. Maybe I is slow free. Before I come to you with the final news, let me take a quick break and tell you about Luggage Pool. And it's time for Luggage Pool. What is Luggage Pool about? Luggage Pool is a platform that offers you solutions to your logistic problems. So for example, if you need someone to move your item from A to B, you go on Luggage Pool and then you book yourself an available driver who's going to help you carry your items from A to B. Let's say you go to IKEA, let's say you go to Mermax, Riga, Ola, XSX Lutz, and you bought this furniture that is bulky and you need someone to carry it from the shop to your house, go onto Luggage Pool and book an available driver. And we'll talk about the affordable price in a bit. But if you also need someone to help you mount and assemble the furniture, Luggage Pool can also allow you to book helpers as well to help you assemble. So if you need manpower, if you need to move things from point A to point B, this is where Luggage Pool comes in. And one good thing about Luggage Pool, and one thing that makes me so passionate about Luggage Pool, is that Luggage Pool was founded by expats, Indian expats to be precise, and they have made it their mission to make sure that you as an expat, as a newbie in Germany, will have things much easier. Because obviously, when you're new here, you don't have a car immediately. Maybe your driver's license is something that you still have to work on, translating and all of that. So you can still settle in and settle in smoothly with luggage pulled by your side. So guys, if you need someone to help you with your logistics, with transport and all of that, please check the link in the description box down below, click on it, create your account, and as I told you, we'll talk about the money. You get 5 euros of your first transaction, so don't waste time. Check luggage pull out, and also stick on this channel because there are other things that luggage pull can give I cannot put in one video. Okay, so stick with me, subscribe to this channel, activate the notification button, and I'll tell you the other things that luggage pull can do for you. Cheers. Welcome back. So another reminder, if you have not yet changed your tires, you should. As you've probably seen, our windscreens are getting frozen by the time we wake up. There's ice on the street, so please, please, please be careful and drive safely, as I've already said. And also make sure that if you've not yet changed for your winter tires, please do. Another thing, another reminder for your motor insurance, please try and get your car insurance. If you want to cancel and change, this is the time for you to do it. Once November ends and you don't do it, game over. You go again next year. So if you think that your insurance is too expensive, this is the time for you to check out Ferrybox, check Films, check 24.de and all of those, and Clark, for example. So check all those sites and try and change your insurance before time runs out on you. If you have any questions, description box or directly to me per email, ldvwithphoebe@gmail.com. Check out our Facebook group as well. Join the group. Check out our Instagram, Twitter and the Facebook page as well. So on Facebook we have the page and we have the group, so check that out as well. Let's grow there and let's interact with each other, and let the expats also get to interact with each other there. Let's ask our questions, so if anybody else knows the answer, we can help each other as well. Thank you so much for watching. Ich wünsche euch eine schöne und besinnliche Adventszeit. The time before Christmas in Germany is a big deal as well, so if you already started preparing for Christmas, I wish you a peaceful and a calm pre-Christmas time. So yes, take good care of yourselves and see you same time next Sunday. Adieu.